Hello, good morning. Welcome to another KHC Couples video devotional. Today is the 16th of December. My name is Jegede Olorunjuwolo, and the topic for today is how love languages can help your marriage, part one. God bless Gary Chapman for this revelation that has delivered many marriages from divorce. It is so insightful, and I would like to share a summary of the five love languages with us. Every issue in marriage about loving each other has been categorized into five major parts. These are the five love languages. Each of us have a primary native language or the mother tongue we speak, with which we communicate with our siblings and parents. In marriage, each spouse speaks a primary love language. This love language also becomes our primary way of perceiving love from our spouse. Husband A says, I do the laundries, help out with cutting the grass and throwing the trash out. I even do the dishes, help my wife with the cooking when she's late from work. I basically take care of the children, yet my wife says, I don't love her. I don't understand. What else does she want me to do? Wife A replies with tears in her eyes. My husband is a good man, but he doesn't talk with me. We don't spend time together as a family. In this scenario, the husband is speaking acts of service, while the wife responds and only understands quality time. The couple above will continue to fight and frustrate each other until they understand the secret of speaking each other's love language. Many marriages are at the verge of divorce, of course, all other things being equal, because the wife or the husband does not feel loved. Here are the five love languages. 1, words of affirmation. 2, quality time. 3, acts of service. 4, receiving gifts. 5, touch. For the first one, words of affirmation. Here, words of appreciation and affirmation are what makes he or she feel loved. The spouse must learn how to speak kind words, reduce criticism or being judgmental. Words like, I love you, appreciate you, I value you, you're a wonderful person, must not be scarce. Such words build his or her esteem and makes he or she blossom. I will stop here today. Join me tomorrow by God's grace as we continue. Meditation for the day. Genesis 2 verse 25 KJV. And the man and his wife were both naked and were not embarrassed or ashamed in each other's presence. Prayer for the day. Number 1. Lord, teach me and give me wisdom and patience to understand and speak my spouse's love language. Prayer 2. Lord, keep my marriage by your power. Prayer 3. Lord, bless my home. Then the confession for the day. I receive the help of God in my marriage. I understand my wife. I am deliberate in my marriage. I understand her love language. I speak her love language consistently. I will make my wife feel loved. I will not neglect her. The love of God is shed abroad in my heart. And so I love my wife. I will speak the right words. I will not be careless with my words. I speak words to build her up and not tear her down. I will give my spouse my time and attention. I will not ignore her. So help me God. Amen. Action plan for the day. Do something that speaks your wife's love language today.
We'd like you to partner with us in Kisses and Us Club. To do so, kindly use the banking information you see on the screen. And for international givers, please navigate to the URL you see on the screen. At kissesandnose.com/give. God bless you as you do so. This devotional is taken from our books for single married, and these books are available on Amazon and on Kada Books. In order to access the books, kindly navigate to the URL you see on the screen at kissesandnose.com/books. If you live in the city of Ibadan, we'd like you to watch with us at Shouts of Grace Center. It's at Joker Plaza, beside Trans Amusement Park, Bodija UI Road, in the city of Ibadan. On Sundays, we have two services by 7:30 and 9 o'clock, and by Wednesday at 6 p.m. It will be our pleasure to have you. Kindly follow us on Cases and Us Club at casesandus.com. You have a lot of resources for your soul.